A lunar eclipse is a celestial event that graces the sky. A lunar eclipse occurs when the sun casts Earth's shadow onto the moon. For this to happen, the Earth must be physically between the sun and moon with all three bodies lying on the same plane of orbit. A lunar eclipse can only occur during a full moon and when the moon passes through all or a portion of Earth's shadow. Sometimes, the moon appears reddish-orange during an eclipse. This is because some of the light from the sun makes it through Earth's atmosphere. But only longer wavelengths make it. These are the red and orange colors. This year has lots to offer skywatchers and stargazers, along with two lunar eclipses. A penumbral lunar eclipse and a partial lunar eclipse. In a penumbral eclipse, the moon passes through an outer region of the Earth's shadow called the penumbra. This is the outer part of the Earth's shadow, in which the Earth appears to cover part of the sun's disk, but not all of it. As a result, the moon's brightness will be reduced, as it is less strongly illuminated by the sun, but the whole of the moon's disk will remain illuminated to some degree. While during a partial lunar eclipse, only part of the moon enters Earth's shadow, which may look like it is taking a bite out of the lunar surface. Earth's shadow will appear dark on the side of the moon facing Earth. How much of a bite we see depends on how the sun, Earth, and moon align. When an eclipse of the moon takes place, everyone on the night side of Earth can see it. About 35% of all eclipses are of the penumbral type, which are very difficult to detect, even with a telescope. Another 30% are partial eclipses, which are easy to see with the unaided eye. The final 35% or so are total eclipses, and these are quite extraordinary events to behold. The first eclipse of the year is a penumbral lunar eclipse, will take place on Monday, March 25, 2024. It will be visible to the naked eye, as 95.57% of the moon will be immersed in Earth's penumbral shadow. Penumbral lunar eclipse occurring at the lunar orbit's descending node in Virgo. This is a very deep penumbral eclipse with a penumbral magnitude of 0.9577 and an eclipse duration of 279.9 minutes. The March 25th eclipse is the 64th eclipse of Seras Series 113. The series is composed of 71 lunar eclipses in the following sequence: 7 penumbral, 23 partial, 13 total, 18 partial, 10 penumbral eclipses. Seras 113 spans 1,262.1 years and runs from the years 888 to 2150. It will be fully visible from most of the Americas, will be seen rising over Australia and Eastern Asia, and setting over western parts of Africa and Europe. The eclipse will be visible any location where the moon is above the horizon at the time, including from the Americas, Antarctica, Alaska, and northeastern Russia. A partial lunar eclipse will take place on Wednesday, September 18, 2024, the second of two lunar eclipses in 2024 and the final partial lunar eclipse of Lunar Seras 118. The eclipse occurs at the ascending node of the moon's orbit in Pisces. Occurring 0.4 days before perigee, September 18 at 13:28 Universal Time Coordinated, the moon will appear 31.8 foot in diameter. This is a relatively shallow partial eclipse with an umbral eclipse magnitude of 0.0869. At mid-eclipse, the moon's northern limb dips just 3.1 into the umbral shadow. The September 18th eclipse is the 52nd eclipse of Seras 118. This series is composed of 73 lunar eclipses in the following sequence: 9 penumbral, 7 partial, 28 total, 8 partial, 21 penumbral eclipses. Seras 118 spans 1,298.2 years and runs from 1105 to 2403. It will be completely visible over western parts of Africa and Europe, South and Eastern North America, will be seen rising over the rest of North America, and setting over the rest of Africa and Europe. What is a lunar eclipse? During a lunar eclipse, the moon appears dark or dimmed. This happens because the Earth is positioned exactly between the moon and the sun, blocking much of the sunlight from reaching the moon's surface. Instead, Earth's shadow is cast upon the moon's surface. Now you might be wondering, if the moon orbits Earth every 29.5 days and lunar eclipses only occur at full moon, then why don't we have an eclipse once a month during full moon? Because the moon's orbit around Earth is actually tipped about 5 degrees to Earth's orbit around the sun. This means that the moon spends most of the time either above or below the plane of Earth's orbit. And the plane of Earth's orbit around the sun is important because Earth's shadows lie exactly in the same plane. During full moon, our natural satellite usually passes above or below Earth's shadows and misses them entirely. Northwest eclipse takes place. but 2 to 4 times each year, the moon passes through some portion of the Earth's penumbral or umbral shadows and one of the above 3 types of eclipses occurs. Unlike solar eclipses, a total lunar eclipse lasts a few hours, with totality itself usually averaging anywhere from about 30 minutes to over an hour. This is due to the large relative size of Earth over the Moon. The Moon's diameter is only about 2,150 miles, therefore casting a large umbral shadow on the Moon. In addition, lunar eclipses are more frequent than their solar counterparts. There are 0 to 3 lunar eclipses per year, although possibly not all at the same location on Earth, where the Moon passes through at least a portion of the Earth's umbral shadow, producing a partial to total eclipse. Earth's shadow can be divided into 2 distinctive parts, the umbra and penumbra. Earth totally occludes direct solar radiation within the umbra, the central region of the shadow. However, since the Sun's diameter appears to be about 1/4 of Earth's in the lunar sky, the planet only partially blocks direct sunlight within the penumbra, the outer portion of the shadow. Astronomers recognize 3 basic types of lunar eclipses. The outer portion of the shadow cast from Earth is known as the penumbral shadow, which is an area where Earth obstructs only a part of the Sun's light from reaching the Moon. The umbral shadow is the inner shadow, which is the area where Earth blocks all direct sunlight from reaching the Moon. A penumbral lunar eclipse is subtle and very difficult to observe. A partial lunar eclipse is when a portion of the Moon passes through the Earth's umbral shadow. Finally, a total lunar eclipse is when the entire Moon passes into the Earth's umbral shadow. During a total lunar eclipse, the sequence of eclipses are penumbral, partial, total, partial, and back to penumbral. The relative distance of the Moon from Earth at the time of an eclipse can affect the eclipse's duration. In particular, when the Moon is near apogee, the farthest point from Earth in its orbital speed is the slowest. The diameter of Earth's umbra does not decrease appreciably within the changes in the Moon's orbital distance. Thus, the concurrence of a totally eclipsed Moon near apogee will lengthen the duration of totality. The amount of refracted light depends on the amount of dust or clouds in the atmosphere. This also controls how much light is scattered. In general, the dustier the atmosphere, the more that other wavelengths of light will be removed, compared to red light, leaving the resulting light a deeper red color. This causes the resulting coppery red hue of the Moon to vary from one eclipse to the next. Volcanoes are notable for expelling large quantities of dust into the atmosphere, and a large eruption shortly before an eclipse can have a large effect on the resulting color. Is it safe to watch a lunar eclipse? The good thing about all types of lunar eclipse is that, unlike a solar eclipse, they are safe to view with the naked eye. This is because lunar eclipses only reflect sunlight, they don't get any brighter than a full moon, which you've probably safely observed many times before. You don't need any kind of protective filters. It isn't even necessary to you.